Hello everyone, I am Ricardo Austin. On a daily basis, I help the world's best brands become more profitable by investing in the consumer experience. If you didn't subscribe to my channel, please do it right now. You will receive an email every time I publish a new video. Today's video is about big data. We have heard this term so often, but do we really know what it means and how to make sense of it? Let's figure this out. First of all, why do we call it big data? It is easy to answer this question if you continue saying big compared to what? In fact, the term big data usually refers to data sets that are too big compared to what humans or common software could analyze. Big data, for example, is the sum of all the data captured by a lot of weather sensors. Big data is the sum of all healthcare information aggregated by a set of wearable devices, or big data could also be the sum of all the news published by the users on Facebook. We could continue with many other examples, but generally we can describe data as big, where the datasets has the following characteristics. Volume, where the quantity of the generated and stored data is enormously large. Usually the size of the data also determines the value and its potential insight. Variety, where the type and nature of the data are diverse. Usually big data comes from texts, images, audio, video, and other forms, often mixed together. Velocity, where the speed at which the data is generated and processed is incredibly high. Big data is often available in real time. It is generated frequently and as frequently is handled and processed. In short, big data is a very large amount of data, which is only insightful if analyzed with sophisticated algorithms run by powerful computers. In fact, big data applications usually run on cloud-based infrastructures that potentially can reach infinite computational power. These type of algorithms, which are created to analyze big data, generally have the goal to identify patterns and trends that describe the dynamics of a certain group of items. This type of analysis creates a fertile playground for the application of other technologies and processes, such as, for example, machine learning, deep learning, and neural networks. All of these together have the goal to brilliantly describe the past and the present, so that we become capable of predicting the future with good precision. The alternative to big data is small data. Surprisingly, small data can be even more insightful than big data. How? Well, subscribe and watch my next videos. Did you find this video interesting? Let me know in the comments. Did you like it? Then click the like button. It costs nothing to you, but it means a lot to me. See you next time.